All right, the first touch. What do you guys think about, you know, should men establish that first, or should you egg the woman into being the one to touch you first, or what do you think?
I think it's a handshake or maybe a light brush on the forearm while you're meeting her.
Yeah, it's a little dependent, I think. Yeah. Sometimes you may get a warmer feeling. Maybe a hug is appropriate for some women. You know,
if you're being introduced by good friends, sometimes it's appropriate.
Yeah, probably not usually initially to a complete stranger. You may not want to hug them. Maybe a handshake is that's pretty harmless. Most people will accept that at an initial introduction.
There are nuances to this, of course, but you're hinting at that you're kind of putting out a scout. You know, at war, you put out a scout to go scout out what's going on.
What's
the lay of the land? And there's a kind of scouting that goes on with, you know, your first physical contact. The nature of her handshake to you. How close to you is she standing before you've even made physical contact? In fact, I think the first way you touch a woman is with your eyes.
Oh, okay.
I think the gaze itself produces feeling, produces emotion.
A reaction.
That's really the first way you've touched, is with your eyes. Hmm. And then from there, does she move closer to you?
Right.
Does she feel your warmth and friendliness, but your mysteriousness that we're going to talk about in part two?
Yeah, eye contact is very important to women, and it's an intimate, it's the beginning of intimacy, really.
Have you ever been approached by a stranger on the street, maybe even like a panhandler, or let's say someone trying to sell you something, you know, like a car salesman, or somebody's on the street with one of those placards, and they're saying, "Hey, we want to show you about our cause, you know, contribute to our charity."
Greenpeace.
They're holding up a sign, or can I interview you for a survey, mm-hmm. and this sort of thing. Have you ever had someone do that to you, but they're like looking at the ground, but they're not really making good eye contact? And you're probably trying to avoid eye contact, but they're not even looking at you. Mm-hmm. They're just talking at you. That's very bad. So in making first touch with a woman, you really ought to feel very comfortable with your eyes even before that, with your gaze, being able to look women in the eye. So in part two, when we actually take you out on the town by iPod or MP3 player, I'm going to want you to work on eye contact first, before even getting comfortable with initiating first touch.
Wow, that is amazing. And then physical touch just comes from the intimacy you've generated from your initial eye contact.
Yes. You know, increased physical intimacy, what some dating teachers out there call kino escalation, this sort of thing. These are kind of unusual buzzwords. I'd rather use everyday person language like touch or physical intimacy. But working your way up in physical intimacy, you're going to find the further you get into it, the closer you get, the more into not just personal space that we cover in the Omega, but intimate space that we cover in the Omega, a certain distance away from each other, that it becomes easier and easier and more natural. It's almost like your bodies are doing the thinking without you having to. And it accelerates to the point where going through increased physical intimacy will actually get to the point where a kiss would be right and maybe even expected. And I cover it in the article that you've received from Maximum Fitness Magazine and is transcribed for you, where we get to the point of a kiss. Now, in part two, Tony and I will tell you about a special kissing technique that encourages the first kiss to happen. Actually, it's pretty flawless. It's really quite remarkable, I think. And it is science-based. But getting to that point, a kiss will be so natural, the environment will set it up for both of you. You had to have gotten to the place, though, where you're physically so close that it could happen naturally, and where you've been looking out at something together, and you naturally, for whatever reason, to continue the conversation, to whisper to each other, your heads will turn toward each other. And at that point, it will feel right or it won't. And if it doesn't, then you haven't done all the prep work first to get to that point. So if you do your homework, you do everything that we're going to cover and we have covered up till now, a kiss will be right when that moment does come. And as you're going to find out in part two, for women, kissing is a kind of end game. It is the cap on their evening. It's the brass ring. It's the gold medal. If they get a kiss and it feels right and natural, they don't need anything else on that given night.